Hey everybody, it's Brian, and welcome to the 87th Qt tutorial with C++ and GUI programming. Today we're going to cover what's called a static compilation. I know quite a few of you have been messaging me saying, how do you do this? Well, first off, we need to explain what is a static compilation. And to understand that, we have to explain the opposite. So, what you've been doing all along is called a shared compilation. And before you, I've got this basic application. It's nothing fancy. I mean, if we run this, it's just quite literally a window with nothing really going on here. Look at the project file and you see that we're calling the core and GUI libraries, and if we open Dependency Walker, this is a software package developed by Steve P. Miller out on Microsoft's website. You can just Google Dependency Viewer, Dependency Walker, and get this program real quick. We'll go ahead and open up ShareTest 2, the program we just made, and you can see how it says there were errors. The reason why they're errors is because we're missing these DLLs. Remember that nasty little thing we went over in our last tutorial where when you try to run a program and you don't have the libraries, it pops back and says couldn't find library, blah, blah, blah. That's called a shared compilation, meaning you're sharing these libraries with other programs. You're not the only program calling the MingWM10 or the Qt Core 4. There could be hundreds of programs calling these. So you're sharing it. It's called a shared compilation. Now, a static compilation, or a static compile as it's more commonly referred to, is where all these things are inside of your exe. So when you give your executable to your friends, your mom, your grandma, whatever, all that code, all those libraries are actually compiled inside of your program. So you only have to distribute one file. Now, I have to put a bit of a disclaimer here. There's no such thing as a pure static compilation, meaning an executable that has zero dependencies. It just does not exist. But what you'll find is that you take your main dependencies, like Ming, Qt 4, Qt GUI, you put them inside your exe, and then you'll still need like kernel 32 and msvcrt.dll, but those will already be on the target machine because they're part of Windows, so you don't need to distribute those. So that's the goal of this tutorial, is to show you how to do a static compilation. Now, I have to admit, I am not an expert at this, and it took me quite a bit of research to figure this out, and a lot of trial and error. So I'm just going to throw that out there. You may know more about this than I do, and that's okay. If you have some helpful hints, share them with everybody. All right, first thing we need to do is we need to actually set up what's called a make spec. Whoops. There we go. In your Qt directory, I have it on C drive, Qt 2010.05, Qt make specs. These are all the make specs for all the different operating systems and compilers that Qt allows. Quite a bit. Now, because we're using Qt Creator, we're using Win32 G++. Now, you could also be using, you know, Win32 MSVC 2010, 2008. This is the Microsoft Visual Studio compiler. So we're just going to go into Win32 G++, and there's this file, qmake.config. And you're just going to open that up. And it's going to bark at you and say, what do you want to open it with? We're just going to choose Notepad. I always uncheck the always use because sometimes that just gets annoying. And we're going to look for this little thing called qmakeLflags right here. qmakeLflags. Now, what this is this is a flag that tells it how to compile it. And you notice mine says dash static. Yours probably doesn't say that because I've already gone through the pain of recompiling Qt, because you're going to have to recompile during this tutorial. So go ahead and open that file up. That's the qmake.config in the makespecs win32-g++ directory, and just add in dash static and then save the file. And you may have all this other gobbledygook back here. Honestly, don't ask me what that is, because I have no idea what some of that stuff is. Some of it seems pretty self-explanatory. Some of it, I just don't know. I'll be brutally honest about that. So add dash static to your qmakeLflags. Save your file when you're done. Then what we need to do is pull up a Qt command prompt. This came with the Qt SDK. You notice how it says setting up a MingW Qt only environment, and it has all this stuff it's doing. You have to open this command prompt, not a normal command prompt. Otherwise, it's going to bark at you and say, I have no idea what you're talking about. You're going to type a command called configure. And be sure, whoops, first off, be sure you spell it right. And do a slash question. And that will give you all of the options for configure. And there are quite a few of them, so you've got a lot of reading to do. But we're going to pick out just the main ones here. If you scroll all the way up, you see how it says shared static. Notice how there's a dot or a little star next to shared, because we're currently in shared mode. If you want to do static, we have to give it a static flag. And you see how it says create and use static Qt libraries. This is really a three-part process. You have to update that qmake.config file. You have to configure Qt, and then you have to compile Qt. And I'll be pretty honest, configuring and compiling takes a long, long time. So we're on step two. We need to configure Qt. So we're just going to type configure. And then we want platform. And this tells it, you know, what compiler to use. Win32-G++. And if you're wondering where I got the Win32-G++ from, it's from our make specs, remember? Win32-G++. That's the compiler that the Qt creator uses. And I should say it's the environment. We want to do a static build, meaning we want to put all those libraries inside of our executable. We want release. If you forget to use release, you may have a DOS window that appears with your GUI applications. So you'll have your main window and then a DOS window off to the side. That's your debug window. So if you do it in normal or just debug mode, you're going to have that little DOS window on almost every program, and it gets really annoying. And then you want to put in no-exemptions. EXC. I'm a horrible speller today. I have to apologize. And you put in no exceptions because some DLLs out there will prefer to be shared. When it goes to compile, it's going to say, don't add me. I want to stay out in my own little DLL. And what no exemption says is, no, you cannot do that. You have to be compiled. Go ahead and enter. And you'll know you typed it correctly if you get this. Which version do you want to use, commercial or open source? Now, I have to throw out another disclaimer. Static compilation is a violation of the open source edition. If you read the license, which admittedly I haven't read in a while, so it may have changed, but if you read the license, what it says is if you use the open source edition, you must do a shared compilation, meaning you must distribute the Qt libraries with your applications. Why? Simple. They want to market themselves. They want people to know you use that. Also, because when you do a shared compilation, a static compilation, certain features are disabled. For example, plugins are disabled. So if you make an application with a bunch of plugins and you think you're all cool and then you do a static compile, it's going to stop working. The reason why is the way memory is treated in the background. So anyways, this is for educational use only. I'm just going to type in an O for open source. Yes, I'm violating the license at this point if I make and distribute a program, so I'm not going to distribute anything with this. Then it says, okay, what do you want to do? Do you want to view the license? Do you want to view the lesser license? Do you accept or do you decline? We're going to just accept. And then it starts just grinding away. And you may think you're actually doing something, but really you're getting ready to do something. This is only step two. What you're doing is you're creating all the make files so that when we go to compile this, it'll all be in static mode. And this is going to take quite some time. So I'm going to go ahead and pause the video. I recommend you go get a drink, order a pizza, watch a movie, something like that. Time for this, depending on your machine, could be anywhere from 10 minutes to half an hour, maybe longer. So I'm going to pause the video and we'll be right back. All right, now through the magic of time-lapse photography, that only took a few seconds, you can see how it says Qt is now configured for building. Just run ming32-make to reconfigure, run ming32-make, conf clean and configure. What does all that mean? Well, it means you need to recompile Qt. So, let's do it. Let's go ming w32 make, and we want to put the sub src for subsource. And I will warn you, this will take an extremely long time. give you some time estimates here. On my machine, which is a fairly beefy computer, it took about 45 minutes the first time I did this. But I also was playing a video game and doing some other stuff too, so I'm sure it would take it much less time. On an older computer that I work with, a laptop, it took about 4 hours. I mean, it was a pretty lengthy process here. So the good news is, once you have actually compiled these, you never need to do it again. So I'm going to press Control C, kill the job, because, well, I've already done this. Now let's jump into Qt here. So when you're doing this, just let it compile all the way. But like I said, I've already done this part, so I'm going to just skip that. And we're going to say static test 01. Put it in the usual location. And notice how nothing's changed so far. I mean, really, we're just doing the same thing that we've been doing. Now, to get this to compile statically, we're not done yet. See, if we actually just run this, and let's let this thing build and compile and all that stuff. Notice how we're in release mode also. Uh-oh. What's this say? Undefined reference to. Yeah, that means we've got a problem with our libraries, and we're going to have to recompile. I stand corrected, so I'm going to recompile, and I'll be right back. Sorry about that. I forgot that I had deleted the static libraries off my computer, so I'm fully recompiled and ready to go. So what we need to do next is go into your project file, and we're going to add an extra line here. We're going to say config, say plus equals static. This is how you tell it you want the static libraries. Let's just save this. Let's give it a good build just for good measure. Notice how it completes successfully this time. And run it. And there's our window. Now let's jump into dependency viewer. Here's shared test 2. Let's open up static test 01, release. There it is. You notice how this thing is 8 megs in size. That's how you can really tell it added all those libraries in there. Now when we open this up in a dependency viewer, it's going to go through and it's going to read it. And you can see how we've got a bunch of DLLs here that it needs. Let me collapse all these. But you're not seeing the Qt libraries at all. So where are they? Well, they're all compiled inside of the executable. You notice how it needs all these other DLLs and drivers and stuff like that. Well, these are all included in Windows, like kernel32.dll. That's part of Windows. Microsoft Visual C Runtime, it's part of Windows. OLLi 32, once again, part of Windows, Shell 32, etc., etc., etc. So you can now distribute your program without the need of any extra libraries. So let's go out and let's actually look at our program here. Here's static test 01. I'm just going to go to properties and show you this thing. 8.35 megs. It's a pretty hefty little program, but you got to remember, everything is included. You can just double click and it just runs. You can copy this onto a USB thumb drive or email it to your friends or whatever you want to do and it'll just run. So that's how you do a static compilation. It's really not that hard. There's only a few key things you need to remember. You need to set the qmakel flags in the config file for your compiler. That's qmake.config. You need to configure for your platform a static release, no exemptions, and then do a ming32 make subsource. And if you ever wanted to switch back, you would just simply take it out and reconfigure for shared. Let's actually show you how to do that. So you would just go back into your Qt command line and go configure. Help if I could spell configure again. And then, of course, platform, and you want Win32, G++, and you would say shared instead of static, and then release. And you don't put the no exemptions in there because you want things to be exempted. And you would just run this. It's the exact same process. It just has the different flag of shared instead of static. And then when you're building your programs, let me bring up Qt Creator again. In your project file, it cannot have this config plus equals static. I mean, you can just take that right out. Now, Before I leave you, I want to show you another neat little thing. This ESE, excuse me, this executable is 8.5 megs. That's a pretty big executable. We want to shrink that down a little bit. So we're going to use another program to shrink that executable down. So first thing we want to do here is just make a copy of this. So we're going to copy, paste. That way we've got a backup of this thing. So what we need to do now is open a command line, and we're going to run a program called UPX. UPX is a software packing program, and I'm going to cheat a little bit and just copy and paste. I'm going to post the links out for all this stuff, so don't worry about hitting Google and trying to find all this as you're listening. UPX, what it does is it takes your file, your executable, and compresses it down. And it does that by doing a lot of voodoo magic that, quite honestly, I don't really understand. I just know it works. There are a lot of other packers out there, but UPX is free. Free is good, right? It's got some commands here, so let's look at the usage. UPX, 1 through 9, a bunch of letters, and really what that says is how much do you want to compress? 1 is fast, but less compression. 9 is slow, but better compression. And then you want some extra options here. Dash O for output file, and then the file you want to compress or decompress. So it's pretty simple. We're just going to do UPX dash 9 for the best compression out there. Dash O, and then the file we want to compress to, and then the file we want to compress. So I'm just going to a little copy and paste magic here. I've already got it all written up. I've got UPX dash 9. Dash O, there's the file I want to output to. Notice the O1C.exe, and then the file we want to compress. You notice how there's no O1C? Well, because we're going to create that. And when you hit enter, if all goes well, you'll see this little progress bar down here, and you can actually see it counting away, 34, 35. It's actually pretty snappy. It's actually one of the better compressors I've used out there. And it says packed. Ratio, 36.56%. Win32PE, static test, O1C.exe. So let's minimize that, and sure enough, there is our other file. And you can see the original is 8.56, and the compressed is 3 megs. Runs the same, looks the same, acts the same. It's just smaller. That's the magic of UPX. So there you have it, boys and girls. Static compilation at its finest. Like I said, I'm not an expert at this, so if you're throwing your hands up in the air going, Brian, how do I do it for Linux? How do I do it for Mac? Quite honestly, I don't know. But what I do know is that I will post links that I found that help me out on my website. So when you go to my website, and let me actually pull it up here. All right, voidrealms.com, and I'll put a link out on YouTube for it. Just go to tutorials and then Qt, and you can just pretty much just go to the last page and I'll have it out here, or you can just type in the word static and search. And I'll bring it up. And I'll, like I said, I'll put as much information into the description as I possibly can, including all the links that I use to figure all this stuff out. So, this is Brian. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video educational and entertaining. And keep up with the feedback. Honestly, this was a user feedback video. I would not have done this if I had not had so many of you saying, how do I do this? So, thanks.